One hour.
Okay. So thanks for invitation first, and okay, I will talk about our recent activity devoted to construction of beta vectors using so-called current approach. And this work was done in collaboration with Nikita Slavnov and Eric Ragusi, and also our young students Artur Gutsaluk and Andrei Ljashik, and the papers are already in the net. And what I'm going to explain today basically around this paper. I start with introduction. I hope everyone here in this auditorium know about Bethe ansatz and Yangian, and I mean at least Yangian R matrix. And but nevertheless, I will give short introduction. And my main goal today is to explain you how explicit formulas for the beta vectors can be written in GL. MN case, Yangian case, or I mean rational R, for rational R matrix, just looking to the partitions of set of beta parameters. So my main message today is when you calculate these beta vectors, basically solving hierarchical relations of nested beta ansatz. Doing this, your set of beta vectors are becomes they becomes separated in the partitions, so they will be parted, and summation goes over these partitions, and the whole structure of beta vectors can be written from these partitions. So this is my message. And this is result of real calculation. The calculations itself are very technical. I will try to avoid these techniques, but nevertheless the result is quite nice to our point of view. Okay, just a few words when Yangian appear. It starts, okay, actually this year is 50 years of Yangian seminal paper. When he consider this model and apply coordinate beta ansatz and found famous Young-Baxter equations and found famous solution of this Young-Baxter equation where P is permutation of two spaces where this operator is acting. And if these are tensor, if the spaces are just linear vector spaces, then these permutations are just permutations of these tensor products, and notations are clear from this small calculations. I just show this to explain what does it mean. M tensor 1 and how it's related to 1 tensor M. And the model which you can have in mind when I will consider it could be just GL2 example, simple GL2 example, when model is constructed from local T operators, and these local T operators consist from Pauli matrices such that when you consider the fundamental representations, you can get from this local L operator standard Yangian rational R matrix. So this is well known how to prove that this monodromy matrix will satisfy RTT relations, and algebraic beta ansatz is a method to construct eigenvectors of this trace of this monodromy matrix. Because this trace is generating function of integral of motions, and the final goal of this business is to construct, to calculate form factor of local operators in this so matrix element for in these states, and next slide is for physicists. I mean, it doesn't work. That when you calculate this form factor, then you calculate, you can calculate the correlation functions, and you can compare these correlation functions calculated numerically and calculated and obtained by experimentally. So this picture from some of papers, Jean-Sébastien Koch, and so this is just maybe not for this auditorium, but I left this slide just in case if you ask me why it is interesting for physicists. So now about the Yangian. So the very idea of Drinfeld was to as follows. So if we have solution of Young-Baxter equations, then his idea was to construct a special deformation of Lie algebra G with generator J A, such that Young R matrix can be obtained from some universal R matrix, which is given by this series taken in this representation. So the idea was to construct such deformation and such element to reconstruct Young-Baxter R matrix from algebraic point of view. And he was succeed. He introduced so-called Yangian. And first formulation of this Yangian is given in a so-called Chevalier basis, when you have to extend original generator but additional head generators, such that commutation relations like this. And beside this, you should impose this terrible Serre relations. Because of this complication, so this terrific horrible is taken from Drinfeld paper. So he really understood that it is almost impossible to use in practical calculations. And it is really true. Fortunately, we will use Yangian. Yangian has other faces. As usual, Yangian is deformation of half of affine algebra. So everyone knows this, yeah? Affine algebra or current algebra can be realized in several ways. So one way is Chevalier generator basis, which is complicated. Other way is RTT realization, which we will use. And third, realization is so-called current or new Drinfeld realization for Yangian and quantum affine algebras. And so we will use this both RTT and current realizations and never use this horrible Chevalier generators of Yangian. When I prepared these slides, I found in the net this paper. Probably you know this lectures and quite not. So this material is taken from there. So what is RTT relation of Yangian? So we consider irreducible representation rho of Yangian into some matrices such that we have universal R matrix for Yangian. And the rational Young R matrix is obtained as a specialization of this universal object in this irreducible representations. But if you apply this representation only in one space tensor component, then you will get so-called T operator, and you can easily obtain from Young-Baxter equation for universal R matrix that RTT relations will be satisfied for this element, and also relation with Chevalier generator is like this. So logarithm of universal R matrix has this extension with J hat generator. Actually, this picture is not really correct. It is possible to write universal R matrix for R matrix for universal R matrix in such a way because of special symmetry of the Yangian, because the universal R matrix in current algebra usually element which constructed in the double. So you need deformation not only half of the current algebra, but also deformation of the full algebra. And so that's why universal R matrix is naturally constructed in the framework of quantum quantum double constructions in the double. Actually, I don't know whether it's possible to write explicit formulas for. Actually, when you know the answer, then of course it's possible apply the symmetry of the Yangian. It's possible to write this formula as well. But Drinfeld probably don't need this and just use this first expansion. So okay, I slowly come to my case. So we will consider the Yangian for GLMN R matrix. GLMN is super. This is supersymmetric algebra. So we will work in supersymmetric graded space CMN. We will introduce parity function, natural parity function. So first M elements are even and rest are odd. And also, we need to modify the tensor product in this situation. R matrix is also modified. Now permutation operator is has supersymmetric versions. And usually in this business, it's convenient to introduce this function. Nikita Slavnov, I don't know, maybe he was who systematically used this notation, but maybe I'm wrong. Maybe somebody else invented this this function, J, F, etc. We will use it today. And basically, our idea is not to consider any concrete model related to this symmetry. We are going to build beta vectors, namely this object B, as a eigenvectors of transfer matrix, just from the matrix element of monodromy of universal monodromy matrix. So we are going to construct B in terms of Tij, which satisfy these RTT relations. The only restriction, I mean, what is natural for beta ansatz, we require that left the part of T matrix which is below the diagonal is annihilate pseudo vacuum vector diagonal. This pseudo vacuum vector is eigenvector for diagonal element with arbitrary functions which are free functional parameters which we can set zero if necessary. So this is our goal. And actually, how to solve this? The solution is nested beta ansatz. I just rewrite RTT relations in terms of explicit for commutations relations between Tij, Tkl. So this is how this commutation looks like. The difference with bosonic case is that now Tij and Tij do not commute. So if Tij is odd, then so if parity of I and j are the same, then everything is cancelled and you have commutativity. If parity of ij is different, then you have either plus here or minus here or vice versa, so there is no cancellations. And so now for odd tij, there is no commutativity. So that's why we will need to, when we want to consider some symmetric product of T of odd Tij, we have to multiply by some prefactor to have such commutativity. Also, we will need this automorphism of antimorphism of Yangian to build dual beta vectors from the beta vectors B. So there are B beta vectors and dual beta vectors can be obtained from this antimorphism which satisfies standard relations. So we also it is useful in this business to introduce gradation so colored function J and F which depends on colored deformation parameter C in this way. That's why in this business it is useful to set C equal to 1. You can do this, of course. You can set, as usual in Yangian, you can set C equal to 1. But then you will you have to write minus to the parity everywhere. So it's more natural to have these notations. And also we will use notations for the product of scalar functions like this. So whenever we will have function, scalar function depending on the set of variables, it means that we have the product of this scalar function when product run over this set of variables. And for even monodromy matrix elements, we can multiply. They are commuting, so there is no important the order of this product. For odd, we have to multiply this product by this prefactor, which is rational function, such a triangular product of rational function h, and then this altogether the product of odd elements of monodromy matrices is symmetric with respect to permutation in terms of this set. So this factor take into account the non-commutativity of the, and of course we will get some at the end Ising determinants, which is given here. Okay, so now how to build this B element? So there is a well-known Tarasov-Varchin construction, which is very old, which is given by such procedure. So you have to take M copies of monodromy matrix, consider the tensor product of M copies of monodromy matrix, multiply it by such triangular product, ordinary triangular product of R matrix, and then take special projection. Take one matrix element in this huge tensor product, and then this guy has to be proportional to beta vector. This was claim by Tarasov-Varchenko, and the main idea to prove this claim was that beta vectors by definition should satisfy so-called co-product property, which means very simple things. If you have beta vectors constructed for one representation or quantum space V1, have set of beta vectors constructed for other quantum space V2, then you have the strict rules how beta vectors for tensor product V1 times V2 is should be written from these two. So this is so-called co-product property, and somehow Tarasov proved that this element satisfied this co-product property. Now, in principle, you can try to calculate this trace, this super trace, but the problem to calculate this super trace, to get explicit formulas in terms of Tij, is very complicated, very combinatorial complicated. Tarasov and Varchenko produced paper in 2007 how to calculate this super trace when T is given at evaluation level. So it means that instead of Tij of U, generic matrix element, you consider its representation in evaluation evaluation. In this case, they were able to calculate this trace, but they were not satisfied by the answer, because the paper they published just 6 years after, and the main dissatisfaction was that you get the answer for these beta vectors as a sum over permutations, over set of beta parameters with combinatorial factors. And this formula is quite useless. You cannot use it for the calculations, real calculations, yeah? And it was one of drawback of the approach. And the idea to overcome this is to partially sum up this sum over permutations to obtain sum over partitions. This is my achievement, which was done when Nikita Slavnov joined the game, and he worked every time with partitions, and we understood how to do this partition. So final formula in terms of partitions are quite natural. I mean, they are very easy to remember, and I hope to I will convince you that you can even remember using very simple rules. You can remember the structure of generic beta vectors for Gellium and algebra, which is quite impressive. Yeah. So we will not go in this direction, and we will use this approach with use current approach, which was introduced by Benjamin Enriquez, Vladimir Rubtsov many years ago, and then together with Sergei Khoroshkin, with Benjamin Enriquez, we somehow elaborated this method and were able to obtain explicit formulas for beta vectors in terms of UQ Gellian. Again, with Khoroshkin, we did everything in terms of sum over permutations, so n factorial size summations. And only with Eric Ragusin and Slavnov, we were able to rewrite these formulas in terms of partitions. And my goal for today, explain you how this could be done. Okay? So, in order to start my program, I need to switch from the Yangian to the double of Yangian. So double of Yangian is very simple things. So if you understand what is Yangian in RTT formulation, then double of Yangian, you just add the second T operator. So the original T operator we call T plus, and you add dual T operator T minus, which are given by such a series. So difference is in which how you expand these elements in powers of spectral parameters. So T plus expanded over negative powers of spectral parameter and minus non-negative. Yeah, the commutation relations are the same for T plus T minus.
Is it rational?
This is rational. I'm talking about rational. Of course, sometimes I will show some formulas in trigonometric case. Because the quantum affine algebra is more the Chevalier generators for quantum affine is more simple, not like this ugly Chevalier generator for Yangian. So you can more easily to explain some notions in the case of quantum affine algebra. I will do it in a second. Yeah, so. We consider, of course, if C non-equals so central elements, so when you consider central extension of double of Yangian, then this commutation will be different for T plus T minus. But we are not going, since we are going to apply in mind our technique only for finite dimension interpretation, when C equals zero, central charge is zero, then it doesn't doesn't matter. So. This double of Yangian is Hopf algebra. Each of T plus or T minus are form subalgebra, Hopf subalgebra, with this Hopf graded Hopf structure. Okay. Yes? Yes? Please ask me a question. R is rational.
Yeah,
so R matrix is rational. So we consider always we consider R matrix like plus permutations. Only rational case. Of course, you may ask me what happened in trigonometric case. The situation morally simple, but as usual there is some problems. In particular, R matrix stopped to be symmetric, for example. Yeah, because you cannot write symmetric R matrix for GL n higher than n 2. I mean, for GL 2 you can do this, but for GL 3 you already cannot write symmetric R matrix. it brings some complications. And Yangian is not, I mean, Yangian is rational deformation of current of affine algebra of Jeul. Quantum affine, yes, but I'm not going to do this, okay? Because there is some technical problems, and I'm not going to do this. So the key point is to use so-called Gauss decomposition. So this was done by Ding, Jing, and Frankel many years ago in the paper in communications. So when they explain how RTT relations can be related to the current relations, of quantum affine. They spoke about quantum affine. I spoke about double of Yangian, but the structure, the idea is the same, just to use Gauss decomposition. And you may use, in principle, you can use these two different type of Gauss decomposition, because when you do nested Bethe ansatz, when you have nested Bethe ansatz, you always has. Okay. Please ask me. I can do. When you do nested Bethe ansatz, so when you work with, when you work with. With T matrix, you can the nesting means that you reduce the problem for matrix of this size to the problem of matrix of this size, embedding the smaller matrix in the big one, and you can do this either in this way or you can do this either in this way. And this is two different ways of resolving nested relation between beta vectors. And in order to have these two different in our language, we need to use these two different Gauss decomposition. And it is clear from this example for Jeul 2-1 that this decomposition, for example, is useful for use this embedding, and this decomposition to use useful for this embedding, something like this, okay? And they produce, both of these Gauss decomposition produce two different but isomorphic current realization of double of Yangian. And idea of Ding and Frankel was not Ding or Ding. Ding. Sorry, I forgot. Yeah. Ah, yes, and there's the Ding there. Yeah, okay, so here's Ding. Okay. Okay, so the idea is that you have to take Gauss coordinates which are close to the diagonal, so with neighboring indices, form these combinations, and what you get, you call that total currents, and then from RTT, you can get nice commutation relations for these currents, and this appear to be exactly new realization of current realization due to Drinfield. And this exercise quite technical, and I'm not going to continue, but I will give you some example how it works, really how it works. So this is how this commutation relation looks like. So it's convenient to use this graded notation. There is no, I put here not all relations, so they are more. When you consider these current realizations, you need to change also coproduct. I will explain why it is natural to change coproduct from the original one, from when we have coproduct like this. Yeah. So this is so-called standard coproduct, which makes standard Borel subalgebra Hopf subalgebras. But in case of occurrent realizations, we change also decomposition into Borel subalgebras. And I will explain. Yes?
Compared to RTT, it's simpler if there are only two terms.
Yes, yes, it is very, this is main advantage of this approach. This is kind of vertex commutation relations, and you can easily use it for practical calculations. This is, thank you for this remark. Okay, so also serial relations. They looks quite horrible, but I have few slides how to demonstrate that it's easy to prove actually these serial relations using using this current approach. So let me give you example how I can calculate this this current realizations for Yangian. This is part of my talk. I mean, current realization of Yangian starting from RTT. So so you start from RTT. Sum of RTT relations like this. You plug in this RTT relation these Gauss decompositions, and to make calculation simpler, you can add you may act by this equality to the vacuum vector. Then all here originally T is sum like this, but this part this Gauss coordinate E always kill vacuum vector. Yeah, it because from this condition you can easily get this condition that Gauss coordinates E always kill because they are you see they are in this right always on the right in this elements yeah okay so. Yes, both for head and but forget about head. We will proceed, otherwise we will never stop. I mean, the moment we forget about head, we work only with one type of current realization. So, so this is this boxed equations is the same of this, written in terms of Gauss coordinate and applied to this to this vacuum vector. Then. You can observe that the only guy which will not commute, I mean, I want to say that this E, you can see this from other RTT relation, that this E will commute with this F and finally killed by this highest vector. And so this sum also disappear. And from this sum, the only term which survive is L equal I. So you need to, then you have Gauss coordinate of the same roots, corresponding to the same roots, and you have to commute this Gauss coordinate using other RTT relations. You can do this. Finally, you will get the only F Gauss coordinate acting on vacuum vector. Then I can say that since this vector generic, I do not specify it. I guess that this equality between Gauss coordinate is true. Okay, so believe me. I mean, it's not easy to explain everything, but so we get this. But then we recall that in double. We have four type of this relation when plus 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 minus minus plus minus minus. They are all the same. They are all the same because RTT relations are the same. So procedure is the same. But the difference is the how you should understood this rational function, because here f plus is a series in negative powers of u, and f minus is series positive powers of v. It means that this guy should be understood as a series over V over U, not inverse. Only, and this mean, sign bigger signified that we consider this series as series over V over U. U bigger than V, okay? The same here, now U less than V, and for equal signs, it doesn't matter. You can use both. Either minus or minus, doesn't matter. Then in order to commute the difference, the commutation relation between total currents, I should sum up all these four relations, because I recall that the total currents Fi is F plus I plus 1 I minus F minus I plus 1 I. Okay, so this is total current. So I just need, no, properly with proper signs, I just sum up these four relations. And I remember this formula, that two zeros, difference of these two zeros is delta function. Yeah? So-called additive delta function. So when I do this, I will immediately recover delta function term in the right-hand side. And this F, which I denoted by I plus 2y, is related, it can be shown that it is related to Gauss coordinate with the same indices, with Gauss coordinate F with indices I plus 2i. But of course, it is not the Gauss coordinate because it is current. And we call this current composed because they correspond to composed roots. This is the same as you start from the simple roots and composed build the composed root generators in standard algebra. Yeah. So then you can play with this right hand side. You can observe, for example, that Gauss coordinate, again, you can obtain this from RTT relations, that Gauss coordinate of these two type are related by commutation with zero mod of the full current, or zero mod of Gauss coordinate, it doesn't matter. Then you finally produce that this composed current is just the product of this current in this order, taken at the same point. Taking this, so this explicit expression, it can be, I will explain how this could be obtained more easily. But before, I just want to say that when I multiply now these equations by u minus v and use this identity, delta function term disappear, and I will get this commutation relation which I marked by red mark in the beginning. So this is how you can proceed from RTT to the current realization. But in this way, you recover this important object, this composed current, which will one of the main object of our construction, because we will relate we'll express beta vectors in terms of this higher composed Gauss coordinate, and then come back to presentation of beta vectors in terms of T. Ding and Frenkel did not do this, and that's why they need to add also serial relations. So if you introduce these composed currents, then you don't need the serial relations. So, but nevertheless, let me just skip this proof of serial relations, because it could be done quite easily to prove that it is really really thing. Okay, let me now come to the point of this different decomposition of Borel subalgebra, because it is important for the whole construction. So in all quantum affine algebra, or even simple affine algebra, or Yangian, or double Yangian, you have always such a picture that you have standard decomposition for positive and negative Borel subalgebra, and you have so-called Drinfield decomposition when you form total currents all together and consider the full algebra as decomposed in these two parts, which is signified by this line. And this is because of the property of the current algebras when you have so-called cyclic ordering, and because of these current generators, just kind of they are just Cartan well construction in the affine case. So in all this affine algebra, there is very simple root ordering which is formulated in this slide, and it is written for quantum affine case now, because for as I told for Yangian with the Chevalier generators of Yangian, it's very difficult to formulate. But the idea is very simple. So if you have three roots from positive part of the root system, and if gamma root is the sum of two root alpha and beta, then either you have only two possibilities to order these roots, either in this way or this way. And then the corresponding generator are given by commutator of corresponding generators e alpha e beta. If after this ordering between alpha and beta there are several roots and several generators, then it means that then you can prove, and this is very very good statement, that commutator of this root of the generators is proportional to the sum of the only inner generator. So it means that when you consider the algebra, current algebra, and when you construct Cartan Weyl basis for this current algebra, then you have natural ordering such that and this ordering can be placed in this way, cyclic ordering. And this ordering easily prove you that any segment of this circle is subalgebra. This is important property of this cyclic one. In our case, we always has either this decomposition to the standard Borel subalgebra when all plus on the right and all minus on the left, or to so-called Drinfeld realization when all current are on the below this line on current E above this line. And let me just show how it works in case of quantum affine. I always like to show this picture, how Cartan Weyl construction produce current algebra realization in this simplest Gel2 case when you can place the root on the plane. So you start from the affine roots, two affine roots for Gel2 case. Actually, it doesn't matter UQ here, it just could be just SL2 algebra. And you have several relation in this case, which means what? It means that you once you can commute these generators to produce non-zero, so-called imaginary root, you can do this second time to produce one more root, but then you cannot produce more, you cannot commute more because you have zero because of cell relation. Yes? But you can commute this guy and this guy to produce double imaginary root, etc. So, and continue to infinity, to the right. Then you can do the same with negative roots, start from this negative, and produce right-hand side. And then this line show decomposition of this Gel2 algebra into positive Borel and negative Borel. This is standard definition of Borel subalgebra. But you can also change situation when you can draw this line in this way to use the Drinfeld decompositions, and then you identify these generators, these Cartan Weyl generators, as a modes of the currents, and then you can rewrite all the commutation relations in the algebra in terms of commutation relations of the algebra. And I cannot write the same picture in Yangian because the Chevalier generator is more complicated. I never know, but in Gel2 case, it's just very illustrative. So I skip head part. And now I came to the relation between how we use this current representation to construct beta vectors. Okay, so from my picture before, it's clear that there is non-zero intersection between Borel subalgebra, standard Borel subalgebra, and current Borel subalgebra. So this part, I mean, these quarters of the circle. And So this intersection, sorry, should be intersection here. I it's not in union, it, it should be inverse, yeah? So if we introduce this intersection, then there is a good theory. If this intersection satisfies this coideal property, actually this is main requirement which you have to use, then you can introduce such a projection which acts on the whole Drinfeld Borel subalgebra and give you just element of from the corresponding intersection. So p plus projections give you the element from this intersection, p minus give you element from this intersection. How to apply this projection? I mean, this is formal definition. You have to first normal order this this current, this product, which means that you have to consider any element of in Cartan subalgebra and in Drinfeld Borel subalgebra and normal order, which means that you have to send all negative modes to the left, all positive modes of the currents to the right. But of course it is clear that it is impossible, it's possible to do with one current, with two maybe. But in general situation it's impossible to do. But the point is that this projection, according to general theory, has very nice property. This property is formulated here. So for any element from this Drinfeld current Borel subalgebra, if you apply delta coproduct to this element, then this element can be presented in normal ordered form. So this property is a direct consequences of these definitions. I'm not going to prove this, but it's very easy. Everyone who can play with Hopf algebra axioms can prove this, yeah? And this is main tool of our calculations. And you will see, I hope, less left 10 minutes, okay? 10 minutes, I will show you how it works. Okay, let me skip this example, which show how it works. So now I came to the to the statement that beta vectors in this picture is given by the product or by the projection of the product of the currents. So for beta vectors, it depends on the beta parameters. It is written here. N capital N is the number of simple roots in GLM and MN algebra, and the you have to consider such an ordered product of the total currents. Why ordered? Because they do not commute, so you have to present some specific order, and then the my claim is that beta vector is the projection of this product. How to prove this? You can, for example, check that by this definition, beta vector satisfy coproduct property, which is already something. And this head part, you can do the same with head part, and you can prove that these two expressions are the same. In GL2 case, you cannot distinguish, you have no different formulas for B and B hat because you have only one T, one two, only one B operator. But when you work in higher rank, you have many B operators, and then beta vectors can be expressed in when you write this T operator in different products. And I will show some examples. Then why this prefactor appear here? This prefactor appear because as I told, f is doesn't commute, but when being multiplied by this prefactor, now this this product of current, normalized product of current, now becomes symmetric with respect to any permutation in each type of beta parameter. So I need this prefactor. Okay, so and then the formula which I claim as a main tool for our calculation looks like this. So you can present any product of current in form in normal ordered form, and of course during when you calculate this formula, this huge sum of a permutation, which is defined here, appear. But if you consider this normalized product, then you can prove that this normalized product of currents is given as a sum of a partition, because a lot of things symmetric inside of this sum, and then you can sum up and remove this nasty combinatorial factor, and final formula is like this. So for us, this is the main tool to calculate this projection, to calculate beta vectors. So why this is beta vectors? Because as I told, we can calculate coproduct of the product of current, and then using this theorem, which state that this projection satisfied this property. So so this is beta vectors, and this is standard coproduct for standard Borel decomposition. And it is the same if you first apply Drinfeld coproduct, which is quite simple because just two terms for each current, and then apply projection. And then using these relations, you can using this coproduct, you can easily prove this coproduct property of beta vectors, and this is what they should satisfy. Moreover, if you can calculate the action of Tij to this beta vector, to this projection. Actually, do not calculate in the projection, just using definition definition of beta vectors and commutation relation between total currents, which is very simple. As you mentioned, then you can prove that this Tij produce linear combination of beta vectors, and moreover you can prove that these rational factors are the same. I'm not going to these details because our young guys found very nice formulas of this action in terms of the partitions, not in terms of this in terms of the partitions. And I hope when everything will be prepared and will be published, maybe somebody of our team will explain you how it looks like. So I stop here, but I just mentioned that when you act by diagonal elements and sum up these diagonal elements, you will get you will prove that this is real beta vectors, because you can prove that if beta parameters satisfy beta equations, graded beta equations, which are looks like so it is written for generic I, and when you write it explicitly for I non equal m and I equal m, then you will get like this. So this is really beta vectors. So okay, 5 minutes. Now the idea of calculations of beta vectors. So this is definition of beta vector as projection of product of currents. Then how to calculate? Separate this product of currents, which corresponds to the algebra, to the smaller algebra, to the algebra GL M minus 1 N. Yes? And apply to this product this normal ordering rule, which I showed you before. Then this normal ordering rule is written as sum over partitions, p minus p plus of something. P plus of product of currents, it is again beta vectors for smaller algebra. Okay? So what you need to calculate to get this relation between original beta vector and smaller beta vectors, just to calculate this projection. And calculating this projection, so you have the product of first type, first root currents, and you have negative projection of the product of all currents from the second to the last. Yeah? you need to calculate, you know how to calculate this projection. And of course, this is very technical, but exactly this way, this nice geometrical picture appears, which allows you to write explicit formula for beta vectors just looking to the partitions. Let me explain you this. So when you calculate this projection, you do the following. So you have to calculate this guy, but just using this property of projection, you can observe that you can put p minus here. Why? Because you can again applying for this product blue one, this normal ordering p minus p plus. Yes, then all the terms when you have non-trivial p plus should be annihilated by this negative projection, because you have p plus on the right. So then it is zero by definition, which means that only the only terms when p minus applied to all the product survive. So you can insert this p minus everywhere, here, here, and here. So finally, you have to calculate this guy. And now you start from this side. You start calculation from this side. So you have to calculate the p minus of the product of currents, product of the currents times other product of the currents, and again p minus modulo sum elements. And in this way, you obtain your result of this calculation is that the dependence on this beta parameter all goes to the rational coefficients, and this beta set of beta parameters decompose into two parts, which denoted like this, such that the size of this element should coincide with size of this subset should coincide with size of this subset. When you when you use this calculate this commutation, what you do? You just try to commute this current through this current, and then when you do this, composed current appear, as I show you before. Yeah, this is composed current. You see difference is two between indices. Composed current appear, and this composed current depends on the original elements of n, but the number of these composed should coincide with this. If this guy, if the cardinality of this set bigger than cardinality of this set, then finally you commute everything, create total current, but the rest of this current will go because they commute. The currents doesn't commute only when they neighbor. So this current can be easily commute and will killed by the positive projection at the end. So finally, such decomposition of the beta of set of beta parameters appear. So you start when you calculate, you start from by acting of the currents dependent on these beta parameters to the currents dependent on these beta parameters, and it result to decomposition this set in two part such that cardinalities of these two sets are the same. Then you continue and you draw such diagram. And I put this red by red because at this point something happened when you do calculations, because at this point you meet so-called odd simple root current Fm. So let me go to the conclusion. Just show you. So this is final formula, but let me give you some example. Okay. So simple gel 2-1. You have just two set of parameters T1, T2. This is odd parameters. So then this is how this decomposition, how this partition looks like. And then looking at these partitions, I can reconstruct this this structure of beta vectors. The rules, let me give you such rules in this example, and then I will finish, okay? So this is my last slide. So you should remember only this picture. If you remember this picture, then everything should be reconstructed just from picture. Let me show you this. So you start from some rational. So the answer for beta vectors, it has some rational prefactors, which compose of this function f, f, and j. And some of this function depends on neighboring set of beta parameters, like in this row and this row. You see 2, 1, 3, 2. And some of this function depends on the same set of parameters along the row. So here t1, this first one, here j of t2, here f1 of t3. Then there is a product of Karepin or Cauchy determinants, which depends only on the set which are one above other. You see, for example, this element is correspond to these two subsets, this to these two subsets. This Isergin determinants correspond to this and to this. Okay, then there is a product of monodromy matrix elements. So the first you start from this corner. So you write the biggest T14, the more complicated monodromy, product of monodromy matrix element from this set. Then the next one, T13 from this one. Then the last one. And you see, and also you put this, the product for the even, this is just normal product of monodromy elements. For odd, you have to have this symmetric combination, which I explained you previously. Then you continue with this line. You have T24 from this set, T23 from this set, and finally T34 from this set. The rest sets depends on the diagonal elements, which correspond to the colors of these beta parameters applied to the vacuum vector. When they apply to the beta vector, they commute, so it doesn't matter the order because they are all proportional to lambdas, to some lambda. So you see, I understood that it's very difficult to believe, yeah, me, that it is possible to do. But I hope you have some flavor that this technique using the current represent exactly because of the simple commutation relations, and because of this, you do like in usual field theory. What you have to do, you just to have to order minus and plus modes, just reorder using the commutation relation in the algebra. They are not so simple like Geisenberg algebra as the usual field theory. They are more complicated, but because of the properties of this projection, you can do this in this complicated situation. This is more or less how it works, but the result is quite nice. Now you don't need to remember this hierarchical nested picture. I mean, Reshetichin invented some picture how by picture you can draw nested relations, but it is quite heavy. Also, Babu Jankarovsky also liked to draw some pictures, but this approach finally put the I hope the our understanding how these generic beta vectors in terms of monodromy matrix element looks like. Of course, could be some simplification of this formula. Maybe the beta vectors which Gromov and company did recently, maybe. But still, we don't know how these two pictures related. It's good questions, interesting questions to continue. Okay, let me stop at this point. Yeah, thank you. I'm ready to answer a question if they are. Sorry. Yeah. So. Well, all what I said, these rules, for example, is written explicitly in our last big paper. So I referred to the paper because I hope we wrote this quite clearly. How having the partitions, write the beta vector. So I just place the partitions for to signify that I can write now the beta vectors for any algebra. Okay, sir, please.
Can I see the G down to slash 2 case?
Okay, this one.
So everything here is, the operators are written in terms of elements of monogamy.
Yes, exactly. Yeah.
So is it possible to generalize the rational case to, for example, Shastri's R matrix?
For what? For which one?
Shastri's R matrix.
Shastri. Hubbard model. Okay. You see, is it possible to reformulate? I mean, to obtain this Shastri R matrix from the algebra, from some algebra? Do you know how to do this? I mean, this is main clue, because you have to find algebra which is behind the model. Here, we consider the any model which corresponds to this rational Young R matrix. I guess that this Shastri R matrix is different. It's not just one plus permutation. They are different, yeah? So the idea how to apply this method is, to my understanding, is to understand what is the algebra behind this model, behind the Hubbard model. What is the current algebra behind the Hubbard model? And then try to apply the procedure like this. I don't know, maybe Samuel know what is the algebra. Yeah, yeah, but from RTT is very mentioned, when you have RTT, you have TT equal many terms, and you lost immediately when you calculate.
Yeah, but at the end, just to write the result, you can also start from just
RTT. Yeah. Yeah, but you are expert. But you are expert. You should ask him actually, because he know how to write this expression from RTT. He knows, not me. Yes.
The way I see this simplification.
Yes.
Is to go to some semi-infinite chains.
We do not say about any concrete chain or concrete model. These are Tij, a generator of the algebra which satisfy RTT. That's all what we need. And also, of course, we need that existence of this pseudo vacuum vector which annihilate the part of T operator of monodromy which is below the diagonal. That's all. Yeah. This the remarks or this refer to the category of representations we consider. We should fix some category of representation when all these generators are acting. Because in our case, this is category of highest weight representation, which means when you consider the product of two currents, each of current is infinite sum in both directions. Then you have to assign, meaning of this infinite product. And the meaning of this infinite can be assigned in this category. Because when you act on any vector in highest weight represent, at some point your generator start to act by zero. Yes? And instead of summation from minus infinity to plus infinity, you will get summation from one infinity to finite number. That's all. So everything resummed in rational functions. So this like, and this is very important, and this is related to the fact also that when you compute these composed currents, they always appear in the normal ordered form. For example, I can come back to the very beginning here. You see, this guy is written in normal order, so all minus are on the left on plus. Because minus minus are They are safe. I mean, they are already. You do not have the terms like f plus terms f minus. And this is always happen. It is related with the fact that we are acting in category of highest weight representation. That's true. Yes, yeah, we have, I mean, it is it published. If you open this big paper, we have 20 pages section when we calculate, explicitly calculate the action of Tij acting on beta vectors, yeah, and show this this rational this function explicitly. We write it everything explicitly. Yeah, yeah. Okay. In this language, to look for the multiplex, it's useless because it's too complicated. The idea is to rewrite. So, what our young guys already did, rewrite these formulas in terms of sum over partition, and then immediately you can rewrite this formula as a multiple action. And this formula looks very, very compact, very natural, and then you can use it to calculate form factor, whatever, for GL2, for GL23. If you like this algebra, yeah, this is already done. Yeah. Of course, the young people usually are quite lazy. They don't want to write papers. They don't like calculations. So now everything depends on Nikita, how they will push them to write to write. But the formulas are very nice. Yeah. Actually, the idea is that you need to write this formula only the action of diagonal element, one of the diagonal element. The everything will be and zero modes, zero mod, and then everything can be reconstructed from these two actions. Hmm. More questions? Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for your attention. Yeah.